Episode 4, Groundwater Moves. Soaring above the Arizona landscape, Blue glides in the air, effortlessly resisting gravity's pull from the earth below. But for water, on the other hand, the journey has much more resistance. The force of gravity drives the movement of water in the earth system. Gravity pulls water from above vertically down deeper into the ground. And then, in an aquifer, groundwater flows down gradient, just like water flows downhill on the surface. Given the small spaces and various materials that it has to move through, groundwater moves at an extremely slow rate. In some areas, the water pools until finally it finds an opening, and it escapes, even if just a trickle. So, how does it get there in the first place? To understand that, we need to journey back above the surface to where it all begins, in the sky. In Arizona, precipitation is highest in the mountains. And down the mountain front it comes. Eventually, the water moves into the ground here and through stream beds. And we get infiltration. Okay, so if we know how water gets into the ground, the next question is, how does it find its way out? Across our state, there are four ways that water finds its way out of the ground. One way is when the water table crosses the land surface. Surface water appears in the form of lakes, rivers, or ponds. Makes sense, right? Because it's all connected. Groundwater is part of the water cycle. In other places, impermeable surfaces channel the water to a lower area. These places are called springs. But there is another type of spring. Artesian springs are where water rises from deep in the earth and is forced out by the tremendous pressure that a confined aquifer is under. Finally, as we already know, humans pump groundwater to the surface for use. How do we use our interconnected water resources? Watch episode 5 to find out.